What is happening, guys? Cowboy here, and welcome on back to another Monster Hunter World Iceborne build video. And today we are taking a look at the strongest of builds in Iceborne, the Sword and Shield support build. And you know it's going to be serious because we got our anime glasses on. The character with anime glasses always has the plan for success. So to take a look at the build in entirety, main things you're going to want here are earplugs 5, wide range 5, free meal 3, speed eating 3, mind's eye, and if you can augment your weapon up, I would suggest trying to work in stun resist as well. But before we jump into all the gear and what we picked and why, the first thing I want to touch on is the perfect rush combo. This is a new combo the Sword and Shield has, and there is a trick to it to get maximum damage out of it. So the base combo, if you leap in and you just, you know, go through the combo, it does pretty respectable damage, you know, 392. But if you prep, if you basically wait a second before each of the perfect rush strikes, you can get a lot more damage out of it. And you notice that red that we have, and you'll notice how we don't see any damage difference really. But what you want to do is hit it with perfect timing here. You see that red. So. You can see how hitting it the moment we flash red, significantly higher. 698 compared to the original combo of 392. So pretty significant difference there. Did feel that was worth touching on. But anyway, to jump on into the gear. First up, we got our weapon, the Radaban Oz 3. Now, there's a couple choices you have when it comes to paralysis sword and shields. You can run with the Great Gyros one, which isn't too bad, has less paralysis, less attack, does have some affinity baked in, but you know that is going to be your choice if you don't want to work in free element. All the other paralysis sword and shields require free element, but I do think it's worth it for the Radaban Oz 3 because it comes with a base paralysis at 360. We have that boosted up to 390. And more importantly, it has a pretty hefty chunk of blue on it, which is that going to be pretty nice, even though sharpness isn't a giant concern here. As for our charm, Friendship Charm, I currently have it at 4. You're going to want to get this up to level 5 as soon as you can, but this is a mainstay of the build. I wouldn't suggest using anything over the Friendship Charm here. As for our gear, you absolutely need to have three-piece Tigrex to make this work. In particular, I have all three beta pieces because I have gems for free meal, but if you do not have free meal gems, you're going to want alpha pieces instead. In this case, we're going for the mail, the bracers, and the tacits, mainly because of the skills they have available, the earplugs and the speed eating. As for our head slot, we're going to go for Zora headgear, which will give us flinch free and some respectable decos, and then Zora spurs for two more nice deco slots and that point of earplugs. Now, when you pull all of this together, this is a rather deco-heavy set, but we have earplugs up at level 5, and that's going to ensure that when the monster's roaring, it doesn't matter. We can still heal. And the reason I like earplugs in a support build is think about all the times that you get caught in a roar and then you catch a fireball to the face, or you're caught in the roar and then you catch a tail slap to the face. We don't want situations like that affecting us, especially because it's our job to keep everyone alive. Moving on from there, we have the wide range at level 5. This is an absolute mainstay of the build. You can do level 4. And then boost it on up with a single friendship jewel until you can level your necklace all the way up. And level 5 wide range I would consider mandatory, mainly because this is going to allow you to get the full effect of all of your consumables in a very large radius. Super important. Attack boost we have simply because of the fact that my sated jewels were already attacked, so I had 2 attack, I had 1 spare piece from Tigrex, so I slotted in a single attack just to boost that to 4 because it's a nice number. Free element we have worked in with release up here, and then release right here, and release right here. Obviously, we need that to unlock the paralysis on our weapon. Free meal coming in from the Seta gems, but as I mentioned, you can use Alpha Tigrex to get that instead. And then speed eating, we have 2-piece on Tigrex, and then 1 gobbler jewel. You absolutely need speed eating, because greatly increasing the speed of your item usage allows you to chug these things down faster than a frat boy pounding Coors Light. As for the other stuff, it's really just icing on the cake, with the exception of Mind's Eye. You know, the Fortify we have from a level 4, same with the Evade Window Slinger capacity. Flinch Free, something nice to have. But Mind's Eye is going to be incredibly important, because as you probably noticed, we only have blue sharpness. And there are monsters that white sharpness will bounce off of. So to help compensate for this, we're just going to run a Mind's Eye Jewel. We don't really care at the fact that we're in blue sharpness. Our goal here isn't to do damage. It's to keep everyone alive and get a couple paralyses on the monster. Paralyses. I don't think that's actually a word. Anyway, With a single paralysis jewel putting you at 390, you have a pretty good chance of paralyzing the monster twice per encounter, depending on how things are going. You'll always get off at least one paralysis, but you may get two depending on the monster and that monster's weakness to paralysis. If you don't want to run paralysis, the other thing I would suggest would be poison. Poison is also always useful to have in encounters, but I feel that since our goal here is going to be to lock down monsters and assist the team as much as possible, I think paralysis shines a little bit more. Now moving on from there, I want to take a look at the items, because with the support build, your items are arguably one of the most important things. So I have a full set already ready to go with this. To go through the things we're going to want here, Mega Potion, this is going to be your main source of healing for you and your team. I like having two Max Potions, and Max Potions will not affect your teammates. However, I do think it's important to have these for an emergency situation, because when you're hunting with a support build, you'll notice very fast that the hunters you're hunting with tend to get lazy. When they realize there's somebody that's healing them and curing their poison and everything else, they stop worrying about taking care of it themselves. So if you go down, all hell breaks loose because all of your hunters are busy bloodlusted. So because of that, max potions so that if you get into a bad situation, you can top yourself off instantly with full health and, you know, keep supporting everyone. Herbal medicine to get rid of poison, null berry to get rid of blights, ration to keep stamina topped off, cool drink or hot drink depending on the environment. Mega Nutrients for that slight increase to maximum health, Immunizer to boost natural healing ability, Astera Jerky to cure bleeding, Dash Juice for stamina, Mega Demon Drug to boost the attack, Mega Armor Skin to buff the defense, and lastly, Might Pill to give everyone that big dick damage increase when the time comes. Now, Might Pills are really interesting with this build. They're pretty significant in terms of the damage buff you're going to provide with them, and ideally there's a couple times I would suggest popping your Might Pill, either after a mount knockdown, after a wall launch, or after a paralyze. Any of those three situations, pop your might pill, chuck down an affinity booster, and watch your team just go ham with top damage. Besides that, it's just kind of standard stuff here. You know, we have flash pods and we have dung pods. Anything gets in the fight, we can get it away. Anything's trying to fly away, we can flash it back down. And that's going to be about it. Now, there's a couple other things you could run. Could run Mushroomancer type stuff. However, Mushroomancer has some weird working with free meal. So I want to say it doesn't work at all with free meal, but it does work with wide range, or it's the other way around. It's something like that. But the point is, free, you're not going to need Mushroomancer. You know, with free meal, 75% chance that you're not going to use items when you actually use them. You're not going to consume them. Having Mushroomancer is just negligible. You don't need to have it. In a similar fashion, you're also not going to really need to worry about dust. You could bring dusts like demon dust and armor dust, but you're doing so much buffing as it is. Honestly, I just don't really feel that it's necessary, but if you're really looking to squeak out that last little bit of DPS, you could do something like a Demon Powder and stack it on top of all the buffs you're already providing. Now, the last thing I want to touch on before we go into the build is your item bar, and I don't know why, but almost no one knows about this. Every time I do it on stream, people are blown away. So if we go into item pouch and we hit triangle, you can see we have our item bar here, and you can rearrange how everything is on your bar. So like kind of right at the start, I have my Mega Potions, my Herbal, my Nulls. I have Might Pills right here. I have all of my buffs lined up. So right at the start, it's, you know, Demon, Armor, Nutrients, Immunizer, Dash Juice, and then Cool or Hot. But you can set up your item bar in advance, similar to how you can set up your radial menu. As for that, I like having Null, Mega, and Herbal, because those are going to be the three main go-tos that you're going to see the most use out of. Affinity Booster is an obvious choice here, since we're looking to buff everybody. And since we're not going to really see a lot of benefit out of the cleanse or the heal boost, because we already have ways to take care of that with just using free meal, I like Temporal Mantle just because it allows you to avoid those one-shots. But after you set up your item bar and all that, you know, same as before, go to items, go to where it's at, hit triangle to register the loadout, and then your items will be saved in the order you set them up as, so that you have easy access to whatever order you prefer them in. So either way, let's jump on into a hunt, show you what this thing is capable of, and as expected, we're going to be doing a group hunt. So for our hunt, we're going to be going after Yangaruga, a very, very formidable foe. Definitely not one you want to take on lightly. Going to go ahead and get everybody all buffed up. Heal ability. Let's make sure stamina's topped off. And we are ready to go. And now we'll pop our might pill, and then we'll put this down for everyone. Anytime someone looks even a little bit hurt, I want him to hit that heal. Now I'm focused on trying to get a mount, because a mount means the monster's on the ground and we get easy DPS. There it is. Boost everybody up again. And even though it's not a huge deal, might as well sharpen on up while we're at it. don't. We gotta sleep on it. This is gonna be a mean wake up. I don't know who's running sleep, but get rid of that guy's poison. Every time you see that little, this skill, free meal has activated. That's all you need. Not like weak points coming in. And it's done. Let's top everyone back off. And look at that. Like, y'all see how easy that was? Ridiculous. And that's the beauty of a support build. It's when there's one person making sure that everybody's taken care of and topped off on health and nobody's poisoned or anything like that. Hunts go super fast. And as you saw right there, the amount of damage I actually did was almost non-existent, but like, making sure everyone else is able to get their damage in, everything just goes oh so smooth. So anyway, thanks for coming on by. Hope you guys enjoyed a look at the Sword and Shield support build. Up next, we're going to be covering an Elemental Charge Blade build, which is a ton of fun to play. So keep your eyes out for that, and I'll see you guys soon. More Monster Hunter World Iceborne builds.